Are you still doing this in Power BI? This is one of the biggest mistakes that I see Power BI beginners make, that they take a bunch of tables and they smoosh it all together and make it one flat table. Now, this is really bad for Power BI. I'm gonna tell you exactly why this is dangerous for you, and I'm gonna show you the right way to do it if you just give me a few more minutes. And if you watch this whole video
and comment the word guide below, I'm going to send you my data modeling guide,
which explains giraffes and hippos and other fun concepts which you can easily follow to do it the right way by creating a data model and not an ugly flat table. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program at learnpowerbi.com, I have helped thousands of business users master Power BI core concepts and build beautiful dashboards and reports in under 30 days. So, hey, I get it. Being a Power BI beginner is hard. It's, I don't know, like trying to swim or something new, and it's always hard at the beginning. And beginners sometimes can take shortcuts, or even more dangerous, whatever tool they're coming from. So a lot of Power BI users are coming from an Excel background. And in Excel, it kind of works this way. You do flatten everything, make it into a giant table, do an army of VLOOKUPs, and then create a pivot table off of that. But if you keep doing that in Power BI, you're essentially digging a trench for yourself. You're gonna get yourself in trouble, because Power BI is not Excel. Power BI works off of concept of what's called a data model. So I'm gonna show you actually a new approach, and then we'll come back to it, and you will easily understand why this approach is problematic. This is what a proper Power BI model should always look like. Down below, you have the data table, which I call a giraffe. Up here are our lookup tables, which I call hippos. Giraffes and hippos are actually intentional terms, and they're gonna help you understand and do the data modeling right. But to find out what they mean, you're gonna have to ask for the cheat sheet. But again, this is a data table, this is a lookup table. What is the advantage of this? The advantage is that you're gonna start off a Power BI model small, and that's how you should start. Power BI is agile BI. You're gonna focus on one element, and yes, I'm using a sales example, but this could be anything. So in your industry, in your data set, figure out what the data table is, which maps the business process, and it's gonna have these lookup tables, the hippos, the who, what, where, when, how. All right, again, more of that in my cheat sheet, but this is what it should look like, and I'm gonna show you why this is better. This is better because, again, Power BI is agile BI, so you're gonna focus on one business process and start reporting on that. And what this is gonna do is this is gonna blow people away. They wouldn't know what hit them. You will build reports on this and they'll go, whoa, how did you do that? And can you do that for us? So a lot of people are gonna come to you and keep asking for stuff. Let's say next we get the support call. So we're selling products in this case, we'll just go with this example, and the support team comes in, and now you have another data table, right? So this is a giraffe. You can see that I like to draw my data tables tall because they're the giraffe, they're the tall ones. And this is gonna be the support. But this gives you the magic of plug and play. So this is like swimming downstream with Power BI. If you swim with the current, it's easy. If you try to swim upstream by flattening it or trying to use Power BI like Excel, well, you're gonna be tired real soon. So plug and play, so support, think about which things it's gonna connect to. When I get a support call, what is it connected to? I'm just gonna plug into the customer. Yeah, I'm gonna say, hey, who are you? Let me know which customer you are, or maybe they came through the ticketing system, I know exactly who they are, and maybe they're complaining about a product and I'll plug it in. So I try to change the color blue. I don't know if you can see it, but the next I'm gonna plug into the calendar table, right? So I'm just gonna go in here and plug in the calendar table. You see how easy it is. I pull in this and I already have these lookup tables and I'm gonna connect them. And now I can slice and dice support data any way I want, not just that. Now that I have it, these tables side by side, I can analyze them together. On the same graph, I can say, show me the sales, right? And show me the support calls, right? So, sorry, I switched the colors, but this is the sales, and I don't know, support calls maybe lags it, right? So support calls are, are lagging in. I'm just making it up. But the idea is you can show them side by side. You can say for every 1,000 products sold for this specific product category, how many support calls were there. You can see support calls per 1,000 products and compare that across products. Is that blowing your mind already? It should, because this is incredible, and it doesn't stop there. It doesn't stop there because you can keep extending it as other teams comes to you. Whoa, how did you do that? Can you do that for us? And now it's the shipping department talking to you. You get their data table and plug it into whichever lookup tables you need to. And maybe the warehouse says, hey, we need help tracking inventory. You bring that data table in, plug into these other tables. And this is the purchase team, which is, you know, procuring the products that we need. And again, bring it in, plug and play. Can you imagine how disastrous it would be if you started with a flat table approach and kept flattening it and adding it on a single table? It just doesn't scale. At one point, it's just gonna break down, which is what we have often seen with Excel. And there's a reason why we use the term Excel hell. You don't want to end up in a version of that. You can, if you don't follow the core concepts and best practice of Power BI, you can end up in Power BI hell, and I don't want that for you. The good news is data modeling isn't complicated, and I've broken it down and explained it in really simple and fun terms like giraffes and hippos
in my data modeling guide. Just comment the word guide below, and I'll personally send it to you.